watahay daawadayaal dadbaadkan barnaamijkana sidaan horey bay idin kugu sheegnay waxaan ku soo qaadanaynaa munaasabad qalin jabin oo ay arday kala duwan shahaadooyin lagu gudoosinayay kuwaasi oo ka qalin jabiyay dugsiga Ubah Medical Academy oo ka mid ah iskuulada Soomaalidu ay maamulaan ee ku yaala gobolka Minnesota hadaba munaasabadii ardaydan ay ku qalin jabinayeen oo ay ka soo qayb galeen waalidiin macallimiin marti sharaf iyo waliba dadweyne kale oo munaasabada lagu casuumay ayaa waxa ay u dhacday sida tan
and honored guests to the 2012 graduation. It's not just simply a celebration of completing their senior year in high school, but instead celebrating the journey that led to this graduation. Every graduating student with a different journey, but the same destination, which is graduation. We recognize families and friends who have sacrificed much so that these graduates could be here wearing their cap and gown. We also celebrate the tradition that these students have brought to us as Ubah Medical Academy, as many of you know, was recognized this year from the Minnesota Department of Education as a reward school, one of the top 15% of all schools in this great state. Thank you, seniors. With that said, none of these graduates would be here without their dedicated teachers. Teachers are all here in the audience tonight. However, the senior class has honored one very special Ubah teacher and selected her as tonight's teacher speaker. Please, everyone, welcome their English teacher, Miss Nicole.
inaan sheego hadal inaan badino ma rabno waxaan ardaydu ku soo dhaweynayaa labadii arday oo senior iska ugu GBS reeyay it gives me great honor to present to you the two seniors who have the highest cum GPA of the senior class of 2012 the senior with the second highest GPA and this year is salutatorian, Sihan Omar Gure. Congratulations. Good job. the senior with the highest GPA of the senior class, and this year is valedictorian, is Anissa Adam Awale. The graduates are 48 in number. Chronologically, they are from 1 to 48. We just took the first 1 and 2. All of you, congratulations.
Our guest speaker tonight, and it's a true honor, is Keith Ellison. Tonight, he represents... Thank you. He represents Minnesota's 5th Congressional District in the U.S. House of Representatives. Representative Keith Ellison's guiding philosophy is based on generosity and inclusion, and his priorities in Congress are building prosperity for working families, promoting peace, pursuing environmental sustainability, and advancing civil and human rights. As a member of the House Financial Service Committee, the Congressman helps oversee the nation's financial services and housing industries, as well as Wall Street. He also serves on the House Democratic Steering and Policy Committee, which decides committee assignments for Democratic members and sets the Democratic caucus policy agenda. Keith was born and raised in Detroit, Michigan. He has lived in Minnesota since earning his law degree from the University of Minnesota Law School in 1990. Most importantly, Keith is the proud father of 4 children. It is truly our honor to welcome Congressman Keith Ellison.
Assalamu alaikum. What a joy it is tonight. What a pleasure. As I look out tonight, I am so very proud of you. As you walk in with your beautiful gowns and your families and your mother, your father, your brother, your sister, everybody here to celebrate you. And as I sit next to your wonderful faculty who have labored hard to make sure that you have an excellent educational experience, I'm filled with a sense of joy. And I'm filled with a sense of wonder for you. But you know what? Graduations are about celebration of achievement. But tonight, I want you to think about something else. I want you to think about gratitude. Say gratitude.
Gratitude.
Say gratitude one more time.
Gratitude.
I want you to think about all that you have come through, all that your family has come through to place you in the moment that you're in now, and the awesome responsibility that you have to make everything you can of yourself. I want you to be grateful for where you are. I want you to think about all the people you have to thank for where you are at this very moment. Some of you have come from abroad to sit here in St. Paul today. You weren't born here, you traveled here. Some of you were born in refugee camp. Some of you had to overcome difficulty, maybe even had to face violence. Some of you had to face political turmoil, and when you got here, you faced a nation. Perhaps when you arrived here, you didn't even understand what people were saying. Am I right? You were like, what are these people talking about? We don't speak this language. You're thinking, wow, the way our culture is different from the majority here. Our faith and our religion is different from the most of the people around us. And you thought to yourself, wow, how are we going to do it? Am I right? But guess what? You did it. You did it. You did it. You did it. You came through it. You came through it all. You walked through the long way. And you made it to the end. But the end that you're at now, just another beginning. Just another beginning. That's why we call this celebration commencement. Because it means it's the start of something. You understand? You know, I want you to know something about our country. I want you to know that, yes, many of you here, maybe not everybody, but most of you all find your roots in Somalia. Am I right? But maybe some don't. Maybe some people from Ethiopia. Maybe some people born right here in the U.S. I don't know where everybody's from. But I think you need to bear this in mind, that there is not one person other than the people who are Native American whose family did not come from somewhere else to be here. They might have come this generation, or maybe their parents came, or maybe their parents' parents came, but everybody came from somewhere else. So I don't want you to ever feel like you don't all the way fit in. You are 100% American and the best we have to offer. And we are looking forward to your contribution to this society. We need you. We need you. As a matter of fact, I need you. I need you to get ready to run for Congress, because I'm getting old up here, you guys. I'm getting older every second, and one of you guys is going to have to get ready to take my place. I can't wait to see the first Somali congressperson. It's going to happen. We already have... We are Oromo too. We didn't forget about the Oromo now. Don't you worry about it. But we want to see you do it. I want you to know that right now, there are several members of the United States Congress who immigrated to the United States from Mexico, from different parts of the world. In fact, the former governor of California, Arnold Schwarzenegger, is from Austria. The governor from Michigan, Jennifer Granholm, from Canada. So there's nothing, MJ, talking to you. There's nothing in this world, brother, that you cannot do if you put your mind to it. Not one thing. Not one thing. I want you to understand that you cannot even understand America without understanding immigration. No, do you understand? If you try to explain America to somebody and you didn't talk about immigration, you would leave that person lost. They wouldn't quite get it. You would need to tell them about the people who were dragged from Africa 14 generations ago, not 14 minutes ago or 14 years ago, 14 generations ago. You'd have to explain the people who came from Europe, the people who came from South America, all coming here to make this great nation. Well, America is not a nation. It's not a nation based on ethnic group. It's not a nation based on language. Because a lot of people speak Spanish or Romo or Somali or all kinds of stuff, right? Our nation, listen to this, is a nation based on our belief in a constitution which says that all men and women are created equal, endowed by their creator with certain inalienable rights, among them life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. If you believe in that, then you're as American as you ever need to be. If you're willing to stand up for those core beliefs, that's as American as you need to be. I'm telling you that our country is tied together on what is in our heart, not what's on our skin. And if you will stand up for that idea, you will be the best American. You will be the best example for any of us to follow. So I want you all to think about yourselves as citizens. Think about yourselves as contributors. I don't care who you vote for, but you better vote. Because if you don't, somebody else is going to vote and you may not like what they're voting for. I want you to be participating in juries. I want you to be knowledgeable about the issues that are facing the community. I want you to know, what are we going to do about urban crime? What are we going to do about deficits and debt? What are we going to do about these problems? You've got to be a part of the solution. Because you are now an educated person. And I hope you will go on and pursue more education. I hope you'll get a college degree, a PhD, why not? You got these valedictorians. Congratulations to the valedictorian and salutatorian. And there's no reason why any one of you cannot continue your education, and we expect that you will. So tonight, I want you to be grateful. I want you to think about who helped you along the way. Who cared about you when you felt nobody did? Who was concerned when you needed a hand? This is a day to hug your mother. This is a day to shake your father's hand and give him a strong embrace. This is a day to thank your teachers. This is a day to thank each other, because some of you guys helped each other make it along the way. Am I right about that? Did anybody in this class get help from a friend? Raise your hand if you did. Everybody. So you all will never forget this day, and your friends for life. And when you get to be an old man like me of 48 years old, you're going to think about the people you graduated from this beautiful high school with. And I want you to think back in great gratitude as to all the sacrifices made for you. And I want you to think about this because I want you to make sacrifices for other people. Because it's not good enough for people just to help you. If you've been helped, you must help. Will you help? Will you be an active, responsible citizen and help America be a better country? Will you help your fellow citizens get the care that they need? Will you clear a path so people don't have to struggle as hard as you did? Well, this is all we can expect from you today. Congratulations to you, your family, and all the class of this wonderful school. Thank you very much, Ubah Medical Academy.
Thank you, Congressman Ellison. As we said, graduation is about memories, and I think you'll recognize some of these faces coming up.
Take one look. Burn down the power and the blue mountain. Thank you. may not be equal to the swift or strong. It's given to the ones who can endure long. I know we can. Everything.
عبد الرحمن جمال عبدي إدريس محمد عبدي نورة مصطفى عبدي أذن عبدي عبد الله كيا حمزة عبد الله عبد عسيس سفيان عبد الله محمد أحمد عبد الله ليس محفوظ عبد الرحمن عائشة محمد آدم محفوظ عبد الرحمن آدم فاطمة أحمد آدم آسيا عبد الرشيد أحمد ماهد عبد الرزاق أحمد نيمو عبد أحمد منصور محمد الشامري عبد النجيب عبد الله علي حمدي حسين علي أنسة آذان عوالي فاطمة عمر دقاني فتحي فارح دغو جبريل موسى فارح شكري علي فارح نيمو أحمد جسد سهام عمر قوري حمدي عبدي حضري ف
Danish Hassan Ibrahim. Muhammad Ahmed Shama. Fartoon Muhammad Chelani. Ali Ahmed Koda. Amina Yusuf Muhammad. Hanan Ahmed Muhammad. Idris Ahmed Muhammad. Salman Abdul Qadir Muhammad. Jamal Osman Muhammad. Ivan Rafiq Muhuddin. Muhammad Abdul Noor. Zahra Adan Osman.
تغنى بالفرح ليل جمعنا كلنا نوره تباشير السعد اللي علينا بول حضوره تغنى بالفرح ليل جمعنا كلنا نوره تباشير السعد اللي علينا بول حضوره بصنع المجد نتهنى ملان الفخر وشعوره ملان الفخر وشعوره إذا يوم الفرح نلنا أمانينا وتخرجنا إذا يوم الفرح نلنا أمانينا وتخرجنا بصنع المجد نتهنى ملان الفخر وشعوره ملان الفخر وشعوره الفرح ليلنا نورة تباشير السعد اللي علينا ضوّر حضورة تكامل مصنع الأجيال من اسمك تكتمل لاما تكامل مصنع الأجيال من اسمك تكتمل لاما على كفك وطين رمال شواط العلم وبحورة شواط العلم وبحورة
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ماتو حالو دبالدغينا ومالي وين ومالتي ايكب علي هاي سكولكا وشعروا ايقالتي امير يوسف او اي دميسي دوكسي السري وحالو تشوقنا ميسي قرادويشكا اي حفلتا وحالو نهاي فيمر كيودن وحالو لها امير الى هاي اخوة قرب قلو تعليمت السري يا جامعة إلى هيا كنا ودي يا سلايو نبغى تكلم ينور كرته وفرح وفرح دوي.
Today we're very happy to have this graduation. It's a landmark for us. It's a milestone for us as a student of Ubah Medical Academy.
السلام عليكم أنا جو عبد القادر ياسين ورسمة وهاد لا يو حافظ سيد ريفرسايد وحنوهم بليني يا دلني يا رضا كسب بحدي Ubah Academy قارعان. محمد احمد شامع او مانتي كوغوليساي انو جراديويت غري فروم هاي سكول مو حنور جينا يا خير يو انو دلال بدن انو جامعات ان شاء الله دمهي مركو ما حسدتي
سنه كان 2002 ان شاء الله كو دلك يا ددك ان فعال الله كدغو يا مسلمينتا ودنك اي كنول هينا وحان قرجينا اني مارتا شميان سيده او قاتن شهاده اني نقطه شهاده صح او حق ددك اي وحو قبطان دلكنا وحو قبطان ان شاء الله باذن الله كريم الهي ما افي قراشان الله الله عفمادي صادق الله سي عمر رير عبادسن ددك يا دلك الله انفع سيو ددك او قلن جريبيين ودا ولادينتا يا ددك اي لا دشتن ددكاس دد قار قبا الله كدغو ددك لا سو هادغري soomaalida aan lahayd dad wanaagsan weeye maanta taqalin jibinaya ma sha Allah jazaakallahu khair salaamu alaykum
ani assalaamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh ana ku hadlaya magaca wax academy high school ana ku hadlaya gabadheeda fortun maxamed jeelani oo ku qalin jabisay 2012 aad iyo aad baan maanta ugu faraxsanahay awraada islaameed oo muslimiintana sidaasi silaak marka waxaan ma aragtay aan Soomaalida u sheegay runtii qaas ahaan umada Soomaaliyeed Ilaahay mahadiisa aan ku shukrino alxamdulillaahi rabbil aalameen ilmaha noo guriga noo jooga oo wax noo bartay oo ma aragtay maanta heerkaas taagan marka insha Allah baan leeyahay sidaasi si ka fiican ma insha Allah tabaarakallah salaam aleekum wa rahmatullaahi wa barakaatuh
assalaamu calaykum waraxmatullaahi wabarakaat maanta aad iyo aad farxad noo ah maadaama ay arday badan ay ka qalin jibinayso iskuulka Ubah Medical Academy aad iyo aad ayaan ugu faraxsanahay boqolkiiba boqol waxaan aad ugu faraxsanahay Soomaalida ka wada qalin jibinayso iskuulka Ubah waxay noo tahay sharaf iyo magac maadaama ay magaalada Minnesota ay dhammaantood ay ardayda oo dhan wax wada baranayaan in gaar ahaan dhalinyarada hadda soo koreysa oo ka wada qalin jibinaya iskuulka Ubah aad iyo aad aan ku faraxsanahay waxbarashadooda maadaama ay rabaan inay jaamacada ama iskuulaadka ay ka baxaaniin waa mahadsantiin asalaamu calaykum waraxmatullahi wabarakaatu
asalaamu calaykum waxaan salaamayaa dadka ardayda graduanaysa soomaalida dhan maanta waxaan ku faraxsanahay gabadha eedaan u ahay meesha graduanaysa u diraya tahniin Fortun Jeelani aniga Aasha Maxamed ah ee iskuulka ugu fiican iskuulaadka the best school Ubah academic Ubah school abba umma santi
bismillaahir rahmaanir rahiim assalaamu alaykum wa rahmatullaahi wa barakaatu aniga Maryan Mahmooda gabadheedii Fortun Jeelani iskuulka Ubah ku garaaj goysay taaniyad u dirayaa iskuulka school fiican yahay ayadana kog jeero weeyay Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
It is truly an honor to serve the Somali community in Minnesota. We are very proud of our 2012 Ubah graduates. They have come a very, very long way and they are all moving forward to college. We are a very fortunate group to have so many great families out here tonight supporting it. So thank you to all your families for the honor of being able to educate your children.
gudahan daawadayaal intaas ayaan barnaamijkeena oo dadbaadkan aan ku soo qaadanay munaasabad qalin jabin oo shahaadooyin lagu gurdoonsiinayo arday Soomaaliyeed oo dugsigaasi ka qalin jabisay ayaan intaas doonayaa inaan ku soo afmeero waa baahdi Soomaali TV oo idile sidaas iyo nabadgelyo iyo kulan dambe oo xiiso leh
Kuwi qubay kuwi qubay kuwi qubay